Are you new to using Semrush? Thinking about using that keyword magic tool, but not sure exactly how to use it? Then stick with me until the end of this video, because I'm going to show you how to use Semrush's keyword magic tool to find long tails to create content for. I'm going to go over what the tool is, as well as a real-world example of how we might use the tool, along with advanced filters that you can use yourself, and then wrap up with 5 tips for how to master the keyword magic tool. By the end of this video, you should have a stronger grasp in terms of how to use this tool to start creating some content ideas that'll help your business get more organic traffic. I've used Semrush since 2013, so I know the ins and outs of the tool. So if you're excited to learn about the Keyword Magic tool, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to get new videos every single week. I help take you from zero to self-starter as we grow your business, get more customers, and hone your business acumen. As usual, if you need to review anything we go over throughout this video, feel free to use the timestamps to do so. But other than that, let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to assume that you know what Semrush is, and if you don't, check out my video in which I review this tool. But it's pretty much a full suite digital marketing tool that you can use to do some keyword research as well as competitive analysis. If you've never tried it out before, you can check out a free trial link in the link in the video description below. By clicking that link, you'll also support this channel. Semrush's Keyword Magic tool is one of the best and easiest ways that I have found to finding long-tail competitive keywords that might work for your niche. If you watched my prior video on easy keyword research ideas, you're well aware that if you use a bunch of free methods, it's totally serviceable. However, you're going to have to do a lot of extra work because you have to use things like Google Autocomplete, in which you're putting in your long tail phrase followed by A, B, C, D, E, F, and so on in the alphabet in order to find potential long tails. And then what we did in that video was we had to run all of those long tails we found through a search volume tool in order to try to figure out whether or not the long tails we were finding were actually good ones. Semrush does all of this for us and more. It'll give us everything from broad to exact to related phrases to the keyword that we are putting into it. And so I'm really excited to show this to you today. Comment below if you're excited to see this keyword magic tool, and let's go ahead and jump into a real world example. Let's say that we are selling laminate flooring and that we want to boost our site's organic traffic. So what I've done is I've gone ahead and navigated to the left-hand side of Semrush and clicked the Keyword Magic tool. And from here, I've typed in laminate flooring. Immediately, what you're going to see from the Keyword Magic tool is that it has found potentially over 70,000 keywords that are related to the term laminate flooring. Furthermore, it breaks things down based on different categories. For example, you can do a broad search, a phrase match, an exact search, as well as a related search. So it'll give you a definition for what each of these things mean, but essentially it gives you an overview and a selection option for any single search that you want to do related to laminate flooring. Another cool thing about Semrush's Keyword Magic tool is that it actually provides a ton of filter options, from word count to volume, keyword difficulty percentage, cost per click, competitive density, SERP features, as well as the number of results in SERP. As I scroll through this, you can see that it actually does some bucketing on the left-hand side for me, which is a super convenient way to expedite my grouping process. If you watched my prior video on easy keyword research, you know how important it is to find related keywords and group them as much as possible into a single evergreen post. So what Semrush does here is that it actually does the first step of the work for me by giving me a general grouping so that I can start thinking about what sort of content pieces I could put together. So this is super helpful on the left-hand side because it gives me filter views. For example, if I only wanted to look at keywords related to installing laminate flooring, I could just click this and it would output the phrases that are related to that and laminate flooring. The other thing that you'll see is that you'll see that the tables are all manipulatable in the Semrush Keyword Magic tool. I can sort things by the keyword difficulty percentage, by the CPC, competitive score, and so on. All right. Now let's go ahead and apply some of these filters and see where the magic of the Keyword Magic tool really comes in. As you saw in my prior video, I like to start out with phrases between 100 and 1,000 monthly searches. The reason why is because we are first building up our authority in this space and we don't quite have the clout yet to get those higher ranking words. And so what I like to do is go for these low-hanging fruits so that I can build up my authority and then get those bigger phrases later on. So I'm gonna do 100 to 1,000 in volume. I'm going to do keyword difficulty up to 80%. And then I'm also gonna go ahead and look for things that are at least 3 words or longer in terms of word count. And from this, what you're going to see is it's going to filter through those 70,000 or so keywords and show me the ones that are potentially fitting of all three of these criteria. From this list, you can see that SEMrush has actually filtered those 70,000 or so keywords down to just 638. So it's done a ton of work for us. Let's say that we wanted to create some content marketing pieces on installing laminate flooring. All we need to do here is click install laminate flooring on the left side here, and SEMrush is going to output the 45 keywords that fall into this space. And as you can see, there are some potentially great long tails here. For example, installing laminate wood flooring, average cost to install laminate flooring, labor cost to install laminate flooring, which is essentially the same thing as the prior one. And there's also other ones like laminate flooring, installation tips, and so on. So these are all keywords that could potentially make for great content marketing pieces. The other thing that I want to note is all of these have a decent amount of volume. They're getting anywhere from several hundred to up to 1,000 monthly searches. So if we're able to rank on page one in the top 3 positions for any of these sorts of things, we could significantly increase the organic traffic of the site. As we go through this list of keywords, you'll probably notice that some of these keywords are related to inquiry-based intent. And what I mean by that is they're questions that people are typing into Google. And so one of the cool things about SEMrush's keyword magic tool is that aside from just being able to filter through all these keywords super quickly, you can actually go up and then click the questions tab. And from here, SEMrush is going to output only the search results that relate to questions specifically. So here you can see that as I filter for just the questions and I apply my same 3 criteria on word count, volume, as well as keyword difficulty percentage, I'm able to see that there are questions like, how much is laminate flooring, how to remove laminate flooring, how to shine laminate floors, all of these great keywords that have low competition scores, low keyword difficulty percentages, and a high amount of volume. If I didn't want to go so deeply into the competitive end of things to start out, I can actually go even further down the list and I can look for things in the several hundred search results. For example, how long does laminate flooring last, or how to stagger laminate flooring. Or if I want to go even further down, I can look at things like, what's the difference between vinyl and laminate flooring? So these are the sorts of things that I mean in terms of when I'm first building out my niche, I can think about the smaller long tail keywords before I build myself up to the ones that get high hundreds, if not thousands, of monthly searches. From this list, I'm starting to get a ton of different ideas for content pieces. I could potentially make just a single awesome post on everything you need to know about installing laminate flooring, or I could create a ton of individual posts that just tackle each of these long tail competitive words. And so as I'm going through these and I'm looking at these long tails, I'm trying to brainstorm in my head what sort of content pieces would buyers potentially find interesting and also be related to the buying process of laminate flooring, so that I can potentially draw up the intrigue through my content marketing pieces and funnel them into converting as a lead. If I only wanted to stay in the questions tab of the SEMrush keyword magic tool, then I could literally just try to answer every single one of these questions, as long as they don't overlap, and create it into something like a weekly series, where it might be something like 5 questions that everybody asks about laminate flooring, or 5 questions that everybody asks about installing laminate flooring. Later on, I could do another one on 5 questions that everybody asks about laminate flooring and the cost of laminate flooring, or whatever, and so on. So what you can see here is that the grouping that SEMrush does for you on the left-hand panel here just jumpstarts your creative process as you start to think about which content marketing pieces to create. There are 3 things that I want to highlight before I jump into the 5 tips when it comes to using the SEMrush keyword magic tool. The first one is I want to draw your attention to the related tab. And what this is going to do is it's going to take the keyword that you insert into the tool and show you some other related keywords that you may not have originally thought of. This is kind of the equivalent in Google to the people also search section at the very bottom of each query. And so if I remove the filters that I have applied here, you can see some of the related phrases to laminate flooring. There's things like, how is laminate flooring sold? What is laminate wood flooring? If I just sort by the volume, I can also see this a little bit more at a higher level. And I can see that there are questions like, what is vinyl flooring? What is pergo flooring? So these are things that aren't necessarily under the umbrella of laminate flooring, but are related because they are other types of materials that people use for flooring. Another thing I want to draw your attention to is the grouping of versus. So when you go back to the all view in the Keyword Magic Tool, you'll sometimes have a grouping with versus as one of the options. This is an absolute goldmine when it comes to content ideas. And the reason why is because it's typically related to high buyer intent phrases that your buyers have for you. So for example, in this space, we have things like laminate versus vinyl being asked, laminate versus hardwood, and so on. These are the sorts of phrases that people love to search for when they're actually very close to making a buying decision. The final thing I want to draw to your attention before I dig into some tips for you is I want to make sure that you check out the SERP features in the Semrush Magic Tool. The Keyword Magic Tool has this feature which allows you to isolate for things like featured snippet, people also ask, top stories, image packs, and more. And this is really cool because what it does is it helps you prioritize which keywords are more valuable than other keywords. Because if you're able to rank for those people also ask or featured snippets, you're going to be able to grow your site's traffic significantly faster than the queries that don't necessarily have these two features. All right, so just to recap, how to use the Semrush Keyword Magic Tool. First, log into Semrush. If you don't have an account, click the link in the video description to start your free trial. Second, go to the Keyword Magic Tool and insert the phrase that you are looking to conduct a search on. The third step is you're going to look at the results and apply some filters. I like to use 100 to 1000 in volume, 3 words or more, and then keyword difficulty up to 80%. Next, go through all the groupings and try to figure out some content ideas that you could potentially take to create onto your blog. From there, you're pretty much done with the Keyword Magic Tool, and it's onwards to content planning and content strategy. If you want to get extra credit, what you can also do is you can go to the Related tab and dig even deeper into your niche and deal with all of your keyword research at one time. It's pretty much as simple as that. So now that we've gone over a real-world example of how to use the Keyword Magic Tool, I want to go over 5 advanced tips that you can use as you begin to familiarize and build your confidence with this particular tool. The first tip that I have for you is to watch for the trend lines. And what I mean by that is there's that column in the Keyword Magic Tool where it's telling you how that long tail performs over the course of a year. What you want to make sure is that all the keywords that you're looking for are not falling on the same trajectory for the trend line. If, for example, you have a downward sloping line, you want to make sure that you get some upward sloping lines in the other direction in terms of content pieces to plan. What you don't want is to create, for example, all of these seasonal pieces related to just the winter, and then you have nothing come the summer to get your business new leads. Make sure that you're looking at these trend lines consistently and carefully so that you don't have seasonality introduced into your organic search traffic. It can be super great to have seasonal content. We actually saw that in the video where I went over how to repurpose your blog content with that landscaping company. Check that out if you haven't already. But you want to make sure that everything is balanced in terms of your overarching content marketing strategy. The second tip I have for you is to check out the CPCs and try to avoid the highest ones. CPC stands for cost per click, and it's pretty much what anybody will pay in order to try to get onto page one for that particular phrase. So things that have a higher CPC are words that generally are closer related to high buyer's intent. It's going to be something like laminate flooring installation. And what that means is that there's likely a lot of money to be made if you were to rank on the first page for that phrase. That being said, though, it's a double-edged sword. If there's a high CPC, then it also means that there's a lot of paid search people that are going to be paying in to get onto page one. And what that can often mean is that there's too many ads and not as many organic results. So what I like to do is I like to look at the long-tail SEO phrases that have a medium to high CPC, but not necessarily fall into the highest bound. The reason why is because you want to be zagging when everyone else is zigging. So if everybody is paying for these high CPC phrases, then you want to look for that sweet spot in the middle where you can still potentially get interested buyers, but not be in as competitive of waters as the people that are paying the highest amount for that particular phrase. The third tip I have for you is to prioritize creating content for long tails that have lower results. What I mean by that is there's that column in the Keyword Magic Tool where it's going to tell you how many results this particular phrase has in the overall search engine. And so what this means when it's a lower amount is that there are less aggregate pages that relate to this long tail that you're looking at. So it means that it's going to be way easier for you to rank on page one than the ones that have millions of results. My fourth tip for you is to make sure that you're always using at least 3 advanced filters. What I mean by that is always using some sort of variation of those things like SERP features, keyword difficulty percentage, volume, word count, and so on. The reason why is because the whole point of the Keyword Magic Tool is to save yourself time in your keyword research. For starters, I recommend using something like keyword difficulty upwards of 80%, word count of 3 or more, and then a volume of 100 to 1,000. And then if you want for extra credit, you can look for just the ones that have SERP features like people also ask, as well as featured snippets. My final tip for you is to double check the zero volume keywords. This is one of probably my favorite tips, and the reason why is because it's often overlooked by all of the classically trained SEOs, and it's something in which it has a lot of actual traffic. It just never gets picked up by tools like Semrush. If you look for keywords in your results and you see something that kind of piques your interest and you think for yourself that it would be something that somebody in your space would be looking for, but it says that it doesn't have volume, it might actually have volume. The easiest way to double check is to do a search along the lines of site:reddit.com or quora.com and then ask the particular question that it says it doesn't have any volume for. And if other people have asked this on these social forums, I guarantee you that there is monthly traffic for these particular phrases. So you can find a ton of diamonds in the rough if you're willing to test some of these out for yourself and just use your intuition. In fact, if you do so and you start to get a ton of traffic for one of these zero volume keywords, tell me in the comments below. I'd love to hear about it. There are two big takeaways I want you to remember about today. The first one is that the Keyword Magic Tool's true strength comes from its ability to consolidate a ton of workflows into a singular workflow. It is the easiest way to do keyword research at scale, and so you want to make sure that you're using every feature that it gives you. The second thing to remember is that mastering advanced filters is the key to number one. And what I mean by that is when you apply advanced filters, you're going to significantly cut down on the amount of time that you need to spend to do your keyword research and find those gold mines that are going to build a ton of organic traffic for you. All right, now it's your turn. Here's what I want you to do next. Comment below what industry or topic you are interested in using the Semrush Keyword Magic Tool for. Then, if you don't already have one, sign up for an Semrush trial account below and then identify at least 25 long tail opportunities using the same criteria that we used today. Then try to come up with 5 cool content ideas that you can think of from the shortlist of 25 long tails. If you feel like sharing, feel free to do so in the comments below and we can give you feedback on your ideas. If you found this video helpful, be sure to hit that like button if you haven't already. I greatly appreciate it, and it helps some more people find this channel as well as this video. Also, feel free to share this with anybody that you think might benefit from learning how to use Semrush's Keyword Magic Tool. Subscribe if you haven't already. Since you've made it this far into this video, you clearly like this sort of content, and I go over a ton of digital marketing tips and tricks, as well as other things to help you grow your business, get more customers, as well as hone your business acumen. Lastly, if you haven't already gotten my digital marketing jumpstart guide, check that out in the link in the video description below. I pretty much give you a ton of digital marketing tips and tricks to help you jumpstart your content marketing efforts. That's it for this time though. I will see you guys next time in which I'm gonna go over what the best way to learn digital marketing is. See you guys there.